Okay, this is the garden. Like I said, you see all the grass that's in between the aisles here. With my knees being as bad as they are and my wife's knees going out her back, you know, we're just doing the best we can to keep the grass out from around the plants. We've got tomatoes here. There's 11 about this size. They're about 6, 7, 8 inches tall. See the first one there, that one there, that one. They're all pretty good. This one here was dying off. But look, it's coming back. It's green and it's coming back. It's not as big as the others. But you see the grass down there? All that right there? We have to pull that out by hand. So it's kind of tedious and difficult on our knees and our back. But the okra, I planted 14 okra plants. And they weren't growing. I came out here with a different type of seed. Or a different, from a different company. Where's this? And then I put these in. See that one growing? See that one growing right there? In between the plants here. Right here. This one here. That one down there. That one. That one. See, now they're in between the stakes. Now in between the 14 stakes, there should be other, there are other seeds I put down there. So if they start coming up too, then we'll have like, you know, 20, 25 okra plants. Over here, the peanuts are coming up. I planted something else. I don't recall even what I planted down here, but the peanuts, those are peanuts right there coming up. They won't be ready till September, October almost. Okay, because they take about 6 months, 5 months to grow. And then here I have watermelon. I got four up front here and two cantaloupe in the back. But look, see how the grass overtook all this? So I let this grow together so my beans, when they come up, see the beans right there? When they get on vine, all that, they can come out here. I got one of those little fences right here. I don't know if you can see that, yeah. And then get a couple of those and just have them out here in the grass area, have them grow out. See in the back, back here is the cantaloupe. Oh, I thought I had three. I've got four cantaloupe back here. Right here, but you see how the rows are where we're trying to weed eat the grass out with the hoe and pull it out by hand. See the grass is overtaken on this here, the back of the okra row. It's a lot of grass, but the plants are still coming out pretty good. And I still think about 90% of what's growing right now will last through till July, maybe even to August. Plus like the peanuts, September. Now this one here, squash, there's one right there, right here, right there, right there. I have four here. There's a different bean plant right here. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bean plants here, and I planted another one up front there. There's a dying one right there by the stake, but I planted one not too far up away from it there. Black eyed peas back here, I've got three planted, plus this one died off and came back. You can see it. But see how the grass around here? It's difficult to get all this up. Like I said, my wife and I both having to get down on this. Our knees are bad. Her back is going, my back went out on me before I was having to wear a brace, so I couldn't do anything out here. But I'm trying, man. I'm trying. If we don't try, then, you know, you don't deserve anything. This is some zucchini squash. Or squash zucchini, rather. I got here and here. And over there in the back, you see that one? There should be another one coming up in there. But see, I planted it in the rows out here, but then look, see the grass overtook it. There should be one. Oh, I can't see, I can't see. Should be one somewhere in here, you know, coming up. Oh, God, my knees hurt. In here, there should be a couple of them coming up. But you really can't see because the grass is overtaking it. And there's some lettuce. In that little row, you can barely see it. I can't see in the camera. Right there is a row. There was two or three seeds for the zucchini in there planted. Again, a different batch of seeds. See, and then I plant these others and they're growing up. Oh man, my knees hurt so bad. Oh man, see, it's hard to even think now because my knees hurting. Jesus. Anyway, that one came up. I can't even think right now because my knees are hurting really bad. And here's the peas. We have six plants coming up. I planted six seeds. You got one right there. That one just now starting to come up. That one there. Got that one there. That one right there. How tall this one is. It's up to this there. Up to the second row. In the first row. And this one here. Well, there's a stake right here that means I probably planted. Where's the stake in the camera? God, I can't see. Oh, right there was a stake. There should be a seed somewhere planted in there. But, you know, that's all I planted. I planted like six. I usually plant one. Everything I plant comes up. Except that stake there, so I must have planted another one there when one of them wasn't coming up. So, but you see how the grass is overtaken. It's kind of a good thing because if you want like a survival garden where it really doesn't look like you're growing anything. But see, I got all these baskets up here and stakes. But everything is, I'd say 90% of everything is growing. Okay, so it's just going to be difficult trying to get through all this little grass and stuff all throughout here. Next year, I'm probably going to stop the garden. It's 40 feet that way and 40 feet across right now. I'm probably going to stop about where this row is here. So it'll take off about 12 feet from here to the edge of that right there. It's about 12 feet right there. I'll take that off. So I'll have room for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, at least 10 rows. I might be at 12 out of it, but 10 rows. Right now, you see how the grass is, man. I'm telling you. It's always something, isn't it? I'm always saying, oh, it's the grass. Well, I've had a broken tiller. I had to buy a new motor, but it was through about 2 months when I could afford it. My knees go out, my back goes out, and this is the best I can do. But I'm doing it. How much are you growing? You know, hopefully I'll get a good harvest. Plus, I got some old tomatoes left over from last year. See, these are those cherry tomatoes right here. Right there, right there. I have to dig those up, get them up, because cherry tomatoes will overtake everything. I don't want cherry tomatoes up here. Might have one plant, and I don't even know. There's one or two in the back there I'm going to try getting. But that's it, because cherry tomatoes will overtake it. And like I say, I dug them all up, and look at them now. They're all right here. I didn't plant these. These are from last year when I dug up what was out here. So, and of course, those onions. I'm going to have to dig up some of those here in about another month. The tops of them are starting to get ready to fall off. Got to keep them in. I think I'm going to go back behind that plant. It's wide enough where I can plant the row straight back behind the two bunches I've got and just go straight back another 9 feet, 8 feet, 10 feet. So it'll be 40 by about 34 feet, 36 feet. 40 by 36 or something like that next year. But anyway, peppers, I got it in the pots over there, and I got tomatoes over there in the pot yet. Tomatoes are about this, almost the size of this one here that was dying off, and it's come back. Actually, the ones in the pot over there are about that size right there. You see that one? Put my cane next to it. That even helps get a... I can't see crap. See, the viewfinder, you can't see anything in it. That's about 5 inches above the ground. That's how big they are in the pot over there. That one right there inside the cage was real sickly. This one here in this cage look like that one right there, if you can see it. Let me see if I can zoom in on it, if I can find it in the viewfinder. Gosh, this really sucks. These viewfinders really are the pits. Right here. See that tomato plant right there? That tomato plant. See how small that is? That's how this one was. And it was brownish. But I kind of weeded out real good the grass and gave it some proto-grow, which helps. Proto-grow is a good thing from Solutions from Science. See that one coming up? A lot of people buy them at the store about the size of this one right here. But like I say, look at these now. You can see all of them about 8 inches tall, 7 to 8 inches tall. So there's going to be a lot of tomatoes this year, thank goodness. And it's different varieties. There's about 5 different varieties out here, man. It's not the crap you buy at China Mart. So, told you, grow a garden, whatever little bit you can, at least if you can get a row and put like 3 different things in it, maybe 4 things in it would be great, but you know, whatever you can get, you got to do something. God, I hate this and think about what's coming.